Hello everyone, in my last video I have described about the joints and the bones of the foot complex. Hope you all have understood that video. Today I have come up with another video mainly targeting the ligaments of the foot complex. So if we say about the ligament, what is a ligament? We should know first. So ligament is a structure in our body. It is elastic, it is fibrous, it is very flexible and it joins a bone to a bone. Okay, it is present over a joint to give strength and stability to the joint. So if we say a foot complex, there are many small bones present in our foot. And we have already said in the earlier video that our foot distributes our whole body weight. So these ligaments in the foot are very strong and provides great stability to the small joints and also helps in distribution of the body weight. So coming to the ligaments of the foot complex, if we go to study everything at a time, it becomes a bit of confusion for us. So I have divided these ligaments in four aspects. Like first we will see about the medial aspect, then we'll come to see the lateral aspect, then we'll come to see the dorsal aspect, and then lastly we'll say about the plantar aspect. So if we see in this chart, in the medial aspect of the foot complex, we get four ligaments. We can see four types of ligaments. The first is the deltoid ligament, or it is also called as the medial collateral ligament. This is one of the most strongest ligament of the foot. It is a fan-shaped ligament. In the diagram later you'll come to see, it is a very strong ligament in the foot. And it is a fan-shaped ligament. So this ligament, to become fan-shaped, actually its fibers are divided into four parts. Okay, so there are these four parts. It is the posterior tibiotalar part, it is the anterior tibiotalar part, it is the tibiocalcaneal part, and the tibionavicular part. Okay, so in the ligaments also, we can think about the ligaments when we read the word itself. See, if we are saying it is a posterior tibiotalar part, that means the ligaments are connecting the tibia and the talar part. Okay, anterior means it is connecting to the anterior aspect, posterior means it is connecting to the posterior aspect. Again, the tibiocalcaneal part, that is, you can say the ligament joins the tibia and the calcaneum. Again, the tibionavicular part, that means it joins the tibia and the navicular part. Next comes the spring ligament in the medial side itself. The spring ligament is also known as the calcaneo-navicular ligament. That means from the word itself we can say it joins the calcaneum and the navicular bone. Okay, so the name comes as calcaneo-navicular ligament. Next is the medial talocalcaneal ligament. Okay, so it is also present in the medial side and it joins the talus and the calcaneum bone. So the name is, as per its connection, the talocalcaneal ligament. Next, lastly, there is a posterior talocalcaneal ligament. It is not a medial ligament, but if we see a diagram, we mostly see this ligament in the medial aspect when we see a diagram from the medial aspect. So I have written it as the posterior talocalcaneal ligament. Okay, mainly it is present in the posterior aspect if we see from the posterior view. Okay, so now next comes the lateral part. If we see our foot from the lateral view, then we get again five types of ligaments. Okay, the first one is the lateral collateral ligament. As we have seen in the medial side, there is a medial collateral ligament. Here we will see it is the lateral collateral ligament. Again, this lateral collateral ligament is also divided into three parts, as you can see, the name being the posterior talofibular ligament. That means from the posterior aspect it's connecting the talus and the fibula bone. Next is the anterior talofibular ligament. That means it joins through the anterior aspect the talus and the fibular ligament. Next is the calcaneofibular ligament. That means it connects the calcaneum bone and the fibular bone. So when we are discussing about this ligaments, let me say that this deltoid ligament is a very strong ligament in the medial aspect and it is mainly responsible for the limitation of the eversion movement of the foot. okay, and here also in the lateral aspect, this lateral cumulateral ligament, it also has three bands which are strong enough to limit the inversion movement. Okay, in the lateral part again, the second comes the interosseous telocalcaneal ligament. That means it is not a band exactly, as we know interosseous means it is a membrane type in between two bones. So it is the interosseous telocalcaneal ligament between the talus and the calcaneum bone. Next is the lateral telocalcaneal ligament. That means in the medial part we have seen the medial telocalcaneal ligament. In the lateral part we'll see the lateral telocalcaneal ligament. Again, it joins the talus and the calcaneum bone in the lateral aspect. Next is the anterior telotibiofibular ligament and the posterior tibiofibular ligament. Actually, these two joins the tibia and fibula in the lower portion. So we have kept it here in the lateral view because it can be very easily seen in the lateral view. In the diagram, in the coming diagram, you will see it very clearly. Okay, even though if you get confused in naming these ligaments, you can just remember that in the medial aspect we have the tibia bone and the lateral aspect we have the fibula bone. So whatever name will be related, it will be related to the tibio. Okay, because in the medial we have the tibia bone. Again, in the lateral part, we know it's the fibula. So everything will be fibular at the end. It will be connected to the fibular bone. Okay. So this is about the medial and the lateral aspects of the foot complex. Next, coming to the dorsal. Next, coming to the dorsal view. If we see it from the dorsum of the foot, we get again 8 ligaments here. Okay, we could have combined this dorsal ligaments with the medial or the lateral, but it would have confused you. So I have divided in this way so that it becomes easier to understand and also it becomes easier to explain. Okay, so if you see from the dorsal view, you will see there are 8 ligaments in the foot. Okay, from the first we'll see it's the dorsal telonavicular ligament. That means you can see it from the dorsum of the foot and the name suggests it joins the talus bone and the navicular bone. Next is another ligament which is a broad ligament which bifurcates and from one bone it gets connected to two bones. So these two are calcaneonavicular and calcaneocuboid. That means it starts from the calcaneum bone, it gets bifurcated and then it's divided into one part goes to the navicular bone and one part goes to the cuboid bone. So it's a bifurcate ligament. Next we will see it's the dorsal cuneonavicular ligament. From the name you see it joins the cuneiform bones and the navicular. Next is the dorsal cuboidonavicular. That means the cuboid and the navicular bone it joins. Next is the dorsal intercuneiform ligament. That means the three cuneiforms are joined within to each other by this ligament. Next is the dorsal cuneocuboid ligament. That means the cuneiform bone, the lateral most cuneiform bone and the cuboid bone are connected. Next we can see it is the dorsal tarsometatarsal ligament. That means all the tarsal bones are connected to the metatarsals with this ligament. Okay, the next is the dorsal metatarsal ligament. That means from the dorsum of the aspect we will see all the metatarsals are joined to each other by this metatarsal ligament. Now coming last to the plantar aspect, plantar that means the sole part, we will see that there are mainly three ligaments present to provide the stability. The first one is the plantar metatarsal ligament. Okay, plantar means it is. Next, coming to the plantar aspect, we can see there are three main ligaments in the plantar aspect. The first one is the plantar metatarsal ligament that is present in between the bases of the metatarsals. That is in the proximal part, the bases are joined by this ligament. Next is the plantar deep transverse metatarsal ligament. This is present transversely between the heads of the metatarsals inferiorly, that is in below the foot, that is in the inferior aspect. Next is the long and the short plantar ligament. The long plantar ligament, it comes from the calcaneum, it goes through the cuboid and then it goes and inserts into the second, third and fourth metatarsals. And the short plantar ligament is very short, very taut and very it has a very much strength to withhold the body weight, and it is also known as the calcaneo cuboid ligament. Okay, now we'll come to each of the ligaments in the next diagrams.